All right.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. We are so thankful to be here tonight.
Amen.
And we give God the praise and all the glory for all that he is going to do and all that he has already done. Amen. And so we're so thankful for the goodness of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for you that are here tonight. Praise God. What a difference a few hours will make.
Yes.
Amen.
As it relates to the change of the atmosphere.
Mm. Yes. Yes.
Amen. And that it is the same with the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
Amen. The Holy Ghost will shift from you.
That's right.
Once we think we've got it figured out. Once we think, amen, that we get comfortable with what he's doing.
Yeah.
The Lord will move.
Yes, he will.
And shift. Hallelujah.
Yes, he will.
And change the atmosphere. Amen.
Praise
hallelujah. Glory to God. So we thank you that we must always be prepared. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We give God praise and we thank him tonight. We're going to open up with this scripture and we're going to pray. And we're going to go forward tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible declares in Psalm 68, hallelujah, beginning at verse 1. Psalm 68 and verse 1. Hallelujah. It says, let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so drive them away.
Yeah.
As wax melted before the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God. But let the righteous be glad. Let them rejoice before God. Yea, let them exceedingly rejoice.
Yeah.
Sing unto the Lord. Sing praises to his name.
Yeah.
Extol him that rideth upon the heavens by his name, Yah. Hallelujah. Rejoice before him. Hallelujah. The father of the fatherless and the judge of the widows is God in his holy habitation. God sitteth the solitary in families. He bringeth out those which are bound with chains. But let the rebellious dwell in a dry land. O God, when thou wentest forth before thy people, when thou didst march through the wilderness, the earth shook, the heavens also dropped at the presence of God.
Yeah.
Even Sinai itself was moved to the presence of God, the God of Israel. Thou, O God, didst send plentiful rain, whereby thou didst confirm thy inheritance, which is which it was weary. Thy congregations have dwelt therein. O God, has prepared for of thy goodness for the poor. The Lord gave the word. Great was the company of those that published it. Amen. We're going to stop there. God gave the word. And great was the company of those that published it. In other words, amen. Those that spoke it.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Those that declared. Those, amen, that uttered their mouth, with their mouth, the word of God. Those that proclaimed the word. Hallelujah. God gave it, we speak it.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. So we thank God tonight. That's why we gather in this sacred place. To hear the word of the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. Let's pray. Father, we thank you. We love you. We give you the praise and the glory for all that you've done. And we thank you, Father. Father, without you, we are nothing. Without you, we can achieve nothing. So, Father, we need you tonight.
Yes, Lord.
Just as we needed you this morning. We need you right now. Hallelujah. This morning is gone.
Yeah. Yeah.
But we need you right now.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
You are the same, Lord.
Yes.
Oh, yesterday, today, and forever.
Yes.
And Father, we thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
There is no diminishing your power.
Oh,
hallelujah, God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. There is no weariness in your voice. There is no feebleness in your arms.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you.
We thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
That you are the God.
Yes, Lord.
Of all, you are the God of all living. You are the God of your people. And we thank you, Father, tonight. And we honor you as we gather in this place. Hallelujah. To give you the praise, to give you all the glory. We magnify you tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We thank the Lord tonight. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank
you,
Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Come on, give me a little. Amen. Minister Hogan, come on, give me a little of praise the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise God. Just give me a little of that. Amen. That little praise song has blessed me now through the years.
Right.
Hallelujah. And I just praise the name of Jesus. He is my rock. He is my fortress. He is my deliverer. In him will I trust. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. That song is a declaration. It is a declarer. You declare. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We declare, in spite of what the devil is doing, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, bless his name. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Praise his name.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, let's lift it.
Praise
Hallelujah.
Thank God.
Hallelujah.
getting ready to yield the floor to our messenger tonight. Minister Osley is coming to give us a word from the Lord tonight. We thank God. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. As she comes. Hallelujah. Let's receive the word of the Lord.
All right.
So if you take the opportunity seriously,
Yes.
Come on now. Yes.
See, I've been reminding him of the benefits.
All right.
Oh, it's about the benefits in this season. I ain't missing in this season. See, I'm looking back on when I was messing up, when I wasn't obeying, I wasn't walking in this in obedience.
Come on.
Right.
And he said, you was missing your benefits.
Come on now.
Come on now.
He said, "You, I'm giving it to you. I'm giving it to you. It's right there. It's right there. It's been there all along, but you've been missing it. You can't blame nobody.
All right.
You can't blame nobody because you've been missing it.
Thank you, Lord.
You can't blame nobody. You've been worried about what's been going on in those years that you couldn't fix.
That's right.
You've been messing up. He said, you've been messing up. When all you had to do was follow me, I feel good.
Yes,
see, for the first time, Bishop, I've been reassured.
Hallelujah.
See, it was a point that I wasn't reassured in my life. But I've been reassured by God. Oh, he said, you're going the right way now.
Hallelujah.
He said, stay on the right track. I just come to encourage somebody.
My.
I may not make it to the word, y'all, because I'm just bubbling. I may not make it to this. But believe you me, it's God.
Thank you.
That's true.
I know you feel bad because, see, I have a heart for people. I love everybody. Just, I want everybody to just serve God. I want everybody to just come on in and just go praise God with me and worship with me. But God said, why you keep trying to bring these folks on these? And he said, I'm trying to, I gave you, I shared this with Pastor Wheaton. He said, y'all can sit down. He said, I gave you something. He said, I gave you great expectation. He said, I gave you great expectation. He said, you took my greatness and you tried to put it in something that was so small. Didn't even belong there.
Wow.
He said, why would you take something that I gave you and put it in something that don't even belong? Guess what happens when you put something that's so great from God and you try to make it fit into something that does not fit? It explodes. It gets too big. It'll burst. Because it can't contain what God gave for you. It was for you. Ain't nothing for them. He said, you keep trying to take these people, bring them up with you. He said, they can't go with you.
No, they can't go.
They can't go. They do not belong.
Come on. Mm.
He said, they don't belong. They don't fit.
All right, now.
Yeah.
Okay. He said, the great expectation that I gave you, you got to be ready. You've been saying, you need it. You want it, God. I want this. I really want this, God. I really want this, God. Yeah. I'm going to get to my message anyway. I'm gone because I'm gonna cut it off. I'm just excited. Right. My God. Everybody turn to Jesus. He's just so good. But we're gonna talk about some of this. What I wrote down. I just wrote down some. My God. Jesus. Okay, y'all turn to Isaiah 43, verses 1-7. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Some people may have a different Bible. I wrote some of mine. I came out of the National American Standard Bible, and I got the King James, because I just kind of like to refer back to see what the difference is. I'm reading a little bit different, but it's all God's
word. All right, amen.
Says, but now, thus said the Lord, your creator, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters,
All right.
I will be with you.
Yes.
And through the rivers, they will not overflow you.
That's right.
I said they will not overflow you.
All right.
When you walk through the fire,
all right,
you will not be scorched.
Huh.
Nor will a flame burn you.
Huh.
For I am the Lord, your God, the Holy One of Israel. Your Savior. I have given Egypt as your ransom, Cush and Saba in your place. Since you are precious in my sight, since you are honored and I love you, I will give other men in your place and other peoples in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east and gather you from the west.
Yeah.
I will say to the north, give them up.
Yeah.
I say, give them up.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And to the south, do not hold them back.
Hallelujah.
Bring my sons and my daughters from afar, from the ends of the earth.
Yeah.
Everyone who is called by my name, and whom I have created for my glory, whom I have formed even whom I have made.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Oh, I thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
I thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
My God.
Thank you,
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lord, help me to make you make sense.
Hallelujah.
My God.
My God.
I began to kind of meditate, and I wrote down a few things from the study Bible. A little bit they talked about Israel. And I'm going to read a little, share a little bit with you. And y'all just follow along with me. Some of it is in the Bible, and some of it the Lord gave me. So, y'all just pray with me. Amen.
Amen.
In spite of Israel's deliberate rejection of the Lord, as her rightful king, God assures them. Fear not, for I have redeemed thee. It indicates a redemption from a physical and a spiritual bondage, as well as the redemption that's yet to come. In addition to redeeming Israel, God also announces that all the nations and the Gentiles will be gathered to him for salvation. And I just want to talk to you a little bit about, you know, when you between a rock and a hard place.
Come on.
We all been between a rock and a hard place.
All right.
But we know that our Redeemer lives.
Yeah.
We know he's our Redeemer.
He's
my Redeemer. One of the main points I like to kind of talk about is how God encouraged the people not to fear him. He spoke it twice in verse 1 and in verse 5. In verse 1 he said, fear not, for I have redeemed thee.
Right.
And in verse 5 he said, fear not, for I am with thee. Those were two commands. He said, fear not God. He's giving you a reason why not to fear him. And that's over in the other verses 1 through 4. I wrote down some notes. In verses 1, he said, reason why you should not fear him, because what I did for you in the past, it proves my love to you and my care for you. I redeemed you from Egyptian bondage, and I called you by name. I told you, you are mine. So if he told you are mine, he's telling you, you can count on me. You can count on me to help you when you're in the deep waters.
Yeah.
Some of us, our waters been troubled in our homes, on our jobs. Me and Sister Gloria can and Elder Sharenda can vouch for how our jobs have been troubled in the past month or so.
Yes,
and how we know if we trust in God in this hour, in this very hour, if we trust in God like we say we are, we know that God is going to be, he's our overcomer. He's our overcomer.
Amen.
He's our overcomer.
Yes, Lord.
So I want you to know that you can count on God. You can count on him to show up when you've been thrown out there in the deep waters.
Come on now.
Yeah, Lord.
When it's raging, even in your home, when the water's raging, when the fire is raging, when everything's been destroyed, when you've lost everything, God wants you to know you can count on me.
All right.
Thank you, Lord.
He said, I'm your Lord. I'm your God. I redeemed you. I brought you out of bondage. You don't have to think that you're still in bondage because of people trying to put you there.
Tell it.
They're trying to put you in bondage. But God began to remind me. me on last Sunday on the way to church. He said, I want to remind you that you are a royalty. All right. He said, you are a royalty. Yeah. And sometimes people want to remind you that you're at the table. But he said, why do you allow people to keep coming at you with all of their problems and all of their issues? He said, when they come to you, he said, I want you to bring them to me.
Come on. Right. Come on.
He said, because I didn't design this for you to carry.
All right.
He said, you're trying to carry too much. You're trying to do too much.
All right.
He said, you're trying to do too much. You're not recognizing that I'm God. You can't do it all. You got a love for people. God said, that's good. You got a heart for people. He said, that's good. He said, but you still got to bring them back to me.
All right. Yes.
Preach.
Come on now.
He said, because you're trying to do it all.
Thank you.
And it's not about you.
Thank you.
He said, it's about me.
Yes.
You got to direct them to me. Yes. Stop trying to direct them to your house as though your house. You got a hell of heaven to put me in.
All right.
As though you can fix it all. I used to be that misfixer.
All right.
Thought I could fix my house. Oh yeah, I thought I could fix it all.
Come on now.
You tell on me.
Yeah.
Thought I could fix it. First day I did, I thought I could fix it. I thought I could pray that whole house, everybody gonna be saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost.
All right.
And the more I tried to do it by myself, I began to find out I couldn't do it.
Come on.
God said, I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna have to show you, because see, you think that you can do this by yourself. You know you in a house ain't nobody saved. It's hard to be in a house ain't nobody saved. It's hard.
That's right.
It's hard to find out that you thinking that you done chose this man, or he done chose you, whoever done chose whoever. All I know is when they ain't saved. And you trying to follow God?
Yeah.
It's a mess.
You gonna catch it.
No, no. That's the truth.
Yeah.
That man or that woman gonna get you hell.
That's right.
Come on.
That's
true. And the kids ain't that far behind.
All right. I'm on that.
Because they rather, in my house, rather be with daddy.
Yeah.
Because mama gonna say, let's pray. Let's go to Sunday school. Let's go to church.
Come on. Yeah.
They don't want to do it.
Yeah.
They don't want to hear what mama.
Come on down.
But I can tell them, I can only give you what my mother told me.
Yeah.
That's right.
I can only tell you what Pharaoh Lee said.
Yeah.
What Pharaoh Lee did.
All right.
It worked for her 14.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
I only got two to raise.
Come on.
My God, it shouldn't have been that difficult. But I didn't know it was that difficult.
Preach.
My mama made it look too easy.
Yeah.
Come on.
11 girls and 3 boys.
Come on.
She made it look easy.
Come on.
I said, my God.
Jesus.
How you put up with all these attitudes?
Yeah.
All right now.
Yeah.
Come on.
How you do this?
Yeah.
I ain't have a tool. And I thought it was, I said, Lord, I'm being punished. What in the world was I that bad? What did I do? That's what I started asking God. What did I do to deserve all this?
Because
my mama, she made that look too much. Mother made that look too easy.
Oh, yeah.
But that woman stood on the word of God.
That's it.
She stood on the word. And she let the Lord order her steps.
Yes, Lord.
She would have to tell you, thus said the Lord, when you got out of our hand.
Uh-huh.
And she said, I had to handle each one differently.
Uh-huh.
Because each one was different.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Believe it or not, ours was different.
Yeah.
I was the one. I had to tell on me. I can't tell on the other siblings. Because she always said, now I'll tell on you first. Before you start telling what somebody else did,
right.
that was the rule in the house. You got to tell what you did.
Come on now.
So every time I got in trouble, she would always use the word on me. Because the word would break me down. I'd be crying. Crying so hard, I just knew God was going straight to a place that I did not want to go. In that place she used to tell us that I didn't know. She said, there is a hell.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And there is a heaven.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They told.
Yeah.
So my punishment, I had to sit for 2 hours and read the Bible. Wow. I really, she just whooped me. I just took the whooping
anyway. Yeah.
But she wasn't, no. She said, this one here, she different. Mm-hmm. She'll be a little easier to break. She believed the word. Yeah. She believed this word.
Uh-huh.
Little bit of girl, but I believe that word. That word was, it was like sound, and it sounded like God himself was talking to me.
Yeah.
But the mother ones, she had to get the extension cord and and y'all remember those big old brooms that they made that used to be that thick, real thick? It was a bunch of those. My friends just come up to our house and in the back door, there was a whole bunch of brooms broke up and they said, I said, no, that it was not. She didn't break it on me. See, she should have been going to jail for some of that.
Back in the day.
Come on now. Some of them, she couldn't use the word of God because it didn't work.
Yeah.
It didn't work. She could talk all day, preach all day. That word didn't work. Not on them. She had to show action.
Come on now.
It's a shame. But I told her, don't take all that from me. I was scared.
Yeah.
I did all kinds of stuff, but I was scared.
Yeah.
I was scared. I was doing stuff, but I was scared. And I was saying, Lord, forgive me. That's what I kept saying. Lord, forgive me. That she don't kill me. My God. My God. But I'm going to get back to the word. He says, I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. He said, you are precious to me. Mm-hmm. How many of you know that you are precious to him?
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
That he loves you with everything.
Thank you, Lord.
Because if you look down further in the scripture, he gave up some stuff. Mm-hmm. Just the same.
That's true. Thank you, God.
Yes, Lord.
He gave it up. Just for us. He said, you are precious to me. He said, look, I have not subjugated other peoples in order to save you. So don't be afraid of the trouble, because trouble is coming.
All right.
It's coming.
Yeah.
All right.
But you've been redeemed. He's already done it.
Thank you.
It's been done. When you look at it, you may think that, okay, God, are you gonna do it, or have you already done it? Mm-hmm. Well, I know in my life it's already done, because I'm waiting on the manifestation.
Yeah.
See, it's according to your faith. Where are you in your faith? It's according to your faith. So are you believing that it's done? Or it's already done?
All right.
See, I'm speaking it's already done because I'm waiting on the manifestation. When my children come in my house and they're like, Mama, how you doing? I'm waiting on the manifestation of God. And now I've said it so much, the oldest one, she says she's waiting on the manifestation of God. That's how she Mama waiting on the manifestation. I'm waiting on it.
All right, yeah.
Because Satan came in and broke my house.
Come on now. Yeah.
He broke it up. It was scattered every which direction.
All right.
But God said in his word that he said over here, he said that he was going to bring us back
Amen. All right, now.
That's the word.
Yeah.
See, we're going to come back together. You don't have to worry about the ones that's not living right.
Mm-hmm. All right, now.
You don't have to worry about it. All your job is to do is just pray.
All right.
That's it.
Don't stress about it.
Come on.
He said, don't be weary in your well-doing.
All right, now. Uh-huh.
You don't have to be.
Thank you,
Lord.
All you got to do is trust God.
Thank you.
Trust that he has already done it.
Yeah.
It's already done.
Already done.
It's already done.
Yeah. Already.
It's already done.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Oh, I thank you, God.
Oh,
thank you.
He said, I'm with you. He said, the judgment of being dispersed into captivity away from your land. He said, this is not my final word. He said, I will gather you again, for you are called by my name.
Right.
Thank you.
He said, I created you for my glory.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
See, he created Ezra for his glory.
Yes,
yes. It wasn't a mistake that they went into bondage. So when something didn't happen in your life, anything in trouble, it wasn't a mistake.
Come on
now.
Right.
Come on. Yes, yes.
It had to happen.
All right.
If you're in isolation right now, because that's where I'm at.
Right.
It had to happen.
Had to happen.
See, I found out it's a beautiful thing to be in isolation.
Come on.
But if you would have asked me this a couple of years ago, I told you, I don't like this. Don't feel it.
Yeah.
Come on.
Feel like I'm by myself.
Yeah, come on.
Feel like I don't have nowhere to turn to.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because it don't always feel good to be in isolation.
Amen.
Right. Right. But God began to tell me, I'm preparing.
Yes, God. Yes.
I'm preparing you while you're in isolation.
Wow. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
I'm going to raise you up.
Yes.
You've been praying to be taught. You've been praying to be in a ministry of holiness.
Hallelujah.
Oh, he led me here.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He led me here.
All right.
See, that's why I love it. I told you I've been reassured.
Thank you, God.
Amen.
See, I was searching. Nobody knew.
Thank you.
I didn't tell nobody. Because he didn't tell me to tell nobody.
Come on.
All right.
Come on. He said, but I'm going to guide you. He said, I'm going to let you go to this church. You can visit over here. He said, but I want you to watch the pool. Watch the pulpit. Watch what come out the pulpit.
Come on.
He said, if you watch it, and if you listen, you're going to understand. Mm. You're going to say, no, this ain't the church.
Come on.
Keep moving. I visited several churches the whole year. I had no shepherd. And I began to cry out to God. Okay, God, this is the end of the year. You promised me.
Yeah.
I need a shepherd.
Yeah. Yeah.
I need to be taught. I don't know what I'm doing out here by myself.
Come on.
It's one thing to be isolated, but when you're isolated and by yourself, you don't feel good.
Come on.
Yeah.
Thank you, God.
It don't feel good.
So true.
And I began to thank God.
All right.
And when he just opened it up.
Mm.
And he began to speak to me. He said, I told you to go.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
He said, they don't know you're coming. They don't even know you're looking. They think you got a church on.
No,
they don't. They don't know why you keep coming over here visiting. You just popped up for Sunday school. Messed up. God said, go to Sunday school. Okay, go to Sunday school. He led me over to Sunday school. Okay? Say, God, I don't know. What are you showing me? What are you showing me? God said, just keep going.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I'm ordering your steps.
Thank you.
order your steps so that you can be taught. Because we're in a season we need to be taught.
That's right. Yes, that's right.
You got to follow. If you don't know how to follow,
because
so many do not know how to follow.
That's right.
Don't know how to obey. Don't understand obedience.
Yes, 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 yes.
Because they think that they got all the answers. Don't understand when you need a shepherd, when you need a first aid, when you need other ministers in place to help you.
Yes, yes, yes.
Because you're trying to get to a destiny. You can't get there by yourself.
Amen. That's right.
You can't get to no destiny by yourself. You need help.
Yes, that's right. You're
trying to accomplish something by yourself.
Jesus.
When God said assemble yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How you gonna do that by yourself?
Come on. Oh God.
God established churches for a reason.
That's true. I believe it.
Amen.
And he brought us together.
Amen.
And I thank God for him. I thank God for what he's doing in this season.
Yes.
I thank God for what he's doing.
Yes.
I cannot express how grateful
I
am.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm just grateful. If he don't do nothing else, if he don't do nothing else, understand me.
Thank you, God.
He's already done
enough. Yes.
Because I began to see the power of God. Oh, he want to do something for his saints.
Yes, yes.
Jesus, I thank you.
Thank you.
Don't stress out in the aisle. I just come to encourage you. Don't be stressed.
Yeah.
You ain't got to be. There's no reason to be stressed out.
Thank you, Lord.
If your job on the line is okay.
Jesus.
All right.
God said, I'm going to open up another door.
Yeah.
Lord, that's right.
Hallelujah. He told me, he said, don't worry about it. You pay him mess.
Come on now.
He said, why are you worried about you ain't a mess?
Come on now.
Why are you storing your treasures?
All right.
You told me you trust me.
That's right.
You told me I'm your father.
Yeah.
Come on now.
That's what you told me. You came in your secret closet and told me I was your father.
Yeah.
What you do? You change your mind now? Because the water's been troubled?
Hey. Come on.
Come on now.
Did you forget that I'm God?
Hey. Come on now.
Thank you, Lord.
Did you forget?
Oh, God.
I told you I was God. I told you I'm coming back for a church.
Yes.
I told you to prepare yourself.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
We don't have that much time.
Come on.
You got more years behind you than you do in front of you.
Come on,
that's right.
Because I can't serve God like that.
Yes,
He wants your undivided attention.
Yes, he does. My.
Oh, thank you, Lord. He wants your undivided attention.
Yes.
He said, now tell you, Michelle, if I take that job, you'll pray for full-time ministry, did you not?
Come on.
I said, I sure did.
Yeah.
I said, I sure did.
Yeah.
Be careful what you ask.
Come on.
Be careful what you say in your prayer.
That's right.
Because see, he don't forget.
Exactly.
You don't forget.
You don't forget
what you prayed for.
Right.
You don't forget what you asked him. Anybody got vision boards?
Hey, glory to God.
All right.
Thank you, Lord.
Anybody got a prayer box in a prayer closet?
All right.
Yes.
See, he promised me some things. I intend on getting them in this season.
All right.
I ain't missing.
Come on.
I have watched myself miss God time after time after time. I'm letting things get in the way. When all I had to do was trust God and stay in his face. Got off path. Got distracted. Allowed other things get in the way.
That's right.
But see, I know everybody here is married. And sometimes when you're single, you gotta pray harder.
Amen.
You gotta stay in God's face. Not so much as you. Some single people, I know some singles don't want to get married. Some do. Don't want to get married. Don't, you know. But when you start asking God to open up a door for you.
Come on.
Yeah.
To prepare you for something that you prayed for a long time. Sometimes it's harder to do it when you're married because you got another, you got a mate.
That's right.
You held accountable for you. Y'all together, y'all one.
Right.
But when you're single, God can use you. That's when you should let God do everything you need to do. You need to do it right
there. That's right.
I believe
that's the truth.
Yeah. That's the truth.
I believe that.
That's the truth.
Whatever you need God to do in that hour, while you're going through that transition,
yes, Lord.
Allow God to do it
yes.
in that season.
Amen.
Because it's so much easier.
I believe
it's so much easier. But I thank God, I'm done.
Wonderful.
I'm going to stop.
Wonderful.
Yes,
Lord.
I bless God for y'all allowing me.
Praise God.
One more time.
Yes,
I thank
yes,
you. Amen.
Praise God.
Yes, Lord. Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
He's good.
Amen. Yes.
To stay in my prayer closet, I'm going to continue to stay in my word. In this season, I ask God to just to help me to the words that's in the Bible to just come off page, just jump off where I can understand it. I can comprehend it. I can translate it to his people because I want people to be delivered. It's a need that the people be delivered.
Yes.
It's more people hurting now.
Yes.
I've never experienced it before in my entire life, even on the job.
Mm-hmm.
So many people don't believe God.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Don't believe that God can do it. And if you hang around, they'll have you not believe. But I thank God for him just taking care of me.
Yes.
Because he's truly been taking care of me.
Yes, Lord.
I've learned that he must force. No matter what state I'm in, he still must
force. Amen.
Minister Owsley for that powerful word.
Yes.
Hallelujah. It is a good thing to be a sold out saint.
Yes.
Hallelujah. See, there's so many wondering, but when you are sold out for the Lord,
wow.
Hallelujah, yeah. You know what your mission is.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
But we thank you for that word. We thank God for the deposit that you have made into this house.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Come on, give God a hand of praise all over the building. Yes. Because you are definitely in the right place at the right time. See, there's no mistakes in God. When you are sold out for him, you can see and hear the direction. So we thank God for you being here. You are a part of this family, and I'm telling you tonight, what a word, amen? What a word. Hallelujah. And we take that. We all need to hear that's a word for right now. What was for this morning was for this morning, but what you give tonight was for now. Praise the Lord. We thank God for that. And we encourage. Let us pray. All of us will pray right now. Well, we're going to pray with you as we leave. But I want to say this. Be encouraged.
Yes.
Be encouraged to keep doing what you are doing. Because that word is necessary. It's necessary. The word is necessary. Hallelujah. And he has not guided you wrong yet. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, sir. And he won't lead you wrong. We serve a God that can do all things but fail. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we're gonna leave tonight. We fired up. Praise God. Thank you for that word. But we never want to leave here without prayer, extending prayer for anybody that may have a need or want to pray or intercede for someone. Because like Minister said, there's so much of a need right now. There are so many people hurting. And so much in the world. So much needed. We're needed, saints. We're needed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And if we could just stand here and pray together. Let's just come together and touch someone. Let's touch and agree as we pray and leave this place. Let's touch together as we pray. Now, I believe God's about to do something. And as she said, in this house, we're unified for a purpose. Amen? Praise the Lord. Let us pray together. Father God in heaven, creators of the heavens and earth and everything thereof, we thank you this evening. Father, we thank you for the word tonight, Lord. Thank you for the message and the messenger, Father. We know that there's no mistakes in you, Lord. And we know that we continue to seek you, Father. You and you alone, but Father, you will never lead us astray. We thank you, Lord, for always being with us in the time of trouble. And we thank you for being who you are, even in the midst of us right now. Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord, for the addition to this house. We thank you for the blessings over this great body. We pray over the families attached. So whoever, all that are here and those that could not make it, bless them right where they are, Father. For whatever reason they could not make it, touch them and bless them, Father. Touch them now, Master, that they may receive that touch that only you can give. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we speak hell. We speak healing to the sick. We speak deliverance to the lost. We speak that the Lord, those that are in bondage, be set free. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, we speak tonight and a blessing abundant in for your kingdom, for your people, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for all of the things that you are doing. Keep your angels about their post, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you. Now, Father, we pray as we leave this place whenever your presence. Angels go before us over the highways and byways, protecting us for the things seen and unseen, granting us safe passage that we continue to do the things of your kingdom. It's our prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, say Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, we call it all so by faith. We thank you and we love you. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, we are. Hallelujah. We're dismissed. Amen. And amen. Hallelujah. We're dismissed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Did you get the
wonderful, 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 wonderful